Hey YouTubers, this is my third try making this video. I don't know what's going on with me in the videos lately, but the enemy does not want me talking to y'all apparently, or else I've just forgotten how. I wanted to share with you a type of curse that I ran across months ago and never did make a video about, just in case anybody's having problems with this, because I got an email recently from someone who was and realized that I'd probably never shared this. I was praying for a woman one day with some other people. And she was a strong Christian, had come to a point in her walk where suddenly, out of the blue, she could not praise, worship, or repent, and didn't know why. And so I began to pray for her, and I said, Lord, what's going on? I know this woman. What is going on? And she said, I've asked God, is there any sin, of blah, blah, blah. He showed me anything there was. I repented. And he said, it's a curse of unbelief. And I said, really? I'd never heard of that one. And he showed me that it had come in through a soul tie with an unbelieving mate that she had been unequally yoked with in the past, who's long gone. The enemy is known to wait for the most opportune time to attack. If you remember, when Jesus was tempted in the wilderness, he rebuked the devil with the word, and it says that the enemy went away to wait for a more opportune time to tempt him. Okay, curses work like that too. They can lay dormant for a while and then suddenly spring up when they can do the most damage. Okay, so I prayed and prayed, and I felt like what she needed to repent of was being unequally yoked. So she repented wholeheartedly before the Lord. We broke the curse. You always have to have repentance before you can break a curse. A curse only comes from lack of repentance for somebody's sin, yours or someone else's. And I say someone else's based on generational curse because I think that they can still exist. I know for sure they can exist on land or on lands where innocent blood has been shed, because the Lord's told me that much. Okay. Had her repent, broke the curse, and commanded every demon associated with the curse to leave in the name of Jesus. Immediately, this woman could repent, she could pray, she praised, worship, all of that. It was an immediate effect, and she's been fine ever since. So I just wanted to share that with you guys, just in case anyone's dealing with something like that, or you know someone who is, because it is a terrible, terrible thing to be a Christian and not be able to worship God, or praise Him, or feel His presence. Or repent, and things like that. So those are our, lifelines for us. So I hope this helps somebody, and God bless you. See you in the next video.